This is Fly Guy. Spider-Punk. This is a cool figure with awesome John Tyler Christopher artwork on there. So we'll take a look at this. Background has some spidey web stuff going on there. Little spidery, you can just see in there, a little spider. Kind of hidden away in all the background, which is kind of nice. I like that little Easter egg. Love Easter eggs and packaging. But very cool artwork, as I said, with the spider pin. Very cool. If you haven't checked out John Tyler Christopher's stuff, for goodness sake, go and check out his stuff. He's awesome. Lots of cool comics, including the new Bosque. Anyway, some text up at the top if you want to freeze frame that. Come on, camera. You're being a pain in the ass today. There we go. Spider-Punk causes major rifts in alternative universe by the corrupt President Osborn. So yes, from a corrupt and different universe. All of these figures will be reviewed on the channel. Most of them, or some of them already have. All of them make parts for Lizard. So collect all 7 to make that rather epic figure, which we will give you a review at the end or the final video. UPC, if you need it, plenty of places to pick it up. Link underneath below. Spider-Punk is pretty damn cool, if only really for that guitar alone and the little pick in his hand, but we'll get a look at that in just a second. He comes with 2 swap-out hands, which, by the way, the old crappy Iron Spidery should have done, but did not. But we do get some thwip hands, or rocking hands in this case, and fists, so a nice swap-out option. And here we get Spider-Punk himself. So pretty good overall, very cool boots. Absolutely love the trainers on them. Just reminds me of kind of Back to the Future for some reason. I don't know why. But really, really well done. I really like this figure and the details again from the comic on the back of the denim jacket, which is really cool. Lots of nice stitching on that. You can just see the kind of detail on there overall. Little touches of silver. Apologies, by the way, if the camera's gone a little yellowy colour. I do not know why. It's kind of bizarrely just decided to go yellowy. Anyway, pretty good looking detail on it overall. We don't really get the spider badge, which is a shame, as we just saw on the packaging, the little spider on there and the little Union Jack, but it's not on the actual item, which is a bit of a bummer. So, oh well, that kind of sucked. Little transfers would have done, surely? No? Anyway, the Spider-Punk looks really good. Silver kind of Mohican on his head looks really good. I bet someone like Shardamus Prime loves this figure because of the Mohican. Cool chest emblem, looking very much like the comic on him there. Love that little jacket, though. The detail in the fabric is really, really nice. Probably one of the best details. Well, it's the only real detail in the figure, because everything else really doesn't have detail. It's one of those very simple bodies from Marvel Legends, which I'm sure you know, which is really just they get away with kind of, you know, solid colours, and they don't really have to do a lot else, which keeps cost down. So probably a relatively cheap-ish figure to do. Every part seems to be reused, apart from the boot. We've seen it before on different Spider-Men in the past. I can't remember which one. We've had so many, but it looks pretty much reused. Not complaining, this is a good Spider-Man body, and as such we get a rockin' head. Plenty of movement all the way around there. No restrictions whatsoever. Shame on the arms, same on the arms, I should say, not shame on the arms, but we get pretty good movement on him there. Articulated joint there, but also you get a swivel too. You get double joints at the elbows, down to the swivel pick arm, which is really cool. I'm glad they gave us a little pick, and back and forth on that too. And on this hand, we've got a gripping hand for the spider, actually playing the guitar, I should say, so that's even better. So I really do like that a lot. Ab crunch, really good. Plenty of movement on that. Swivel waist, unrestricted. 2 pins up at the top. Thigh swivel, double joints at the knees, and we get that boot swivel, and we get rocking ankles too. Pickles, for those things that Hasbro never really give us. They're pretty shallow though. But Spider-Punk, I think, is excellent. You either love or hate it. I think when we reviewed it recently, we were talking about it on the 6-inch show that Matt and I do, and I don't think he was really up for it from memory. I can't remember, but I love it. I think it's really fun. I think it's a really fun, kind of quirky one to have out there. And if you don't like it, don't buy it. But the guitar is one of the standout pieces, I had to be said. Now, it's very plain in the packaging. Someone's going to customise this. I sure shit am. In the packaging, it's a little bit bendy, so you got to really fix that a little bit. But you can't really just a white guitar, no paint. That's just a little lazy, Hasbro. I mean, the whole figure doesn't have a lot of paint really on it anyway, and you never painted the badge. So, kind of doing the bare minimum here, dialing in a little bit, but we do now have a guitar mold, so I bet you we'll see that at one point in the line for someone, somewhere, I don't know why. But yes, we got loads of little detail on that, but just no paint. We got a blue piece there, a little blue dot for some buttons, and a black strap. So pretty plain, and it doesn't... is that articulated? Can I move that? It seems to be. It actually looks as if it's just moulded straight on it. I don't know. I'm not going to play around with that because this is probably going to break and I don't want it to. But yeah, it looks as if it's all moulded on that one part. Anyway, which doesn't really give you a lot of flexibility, but you get some great poses with this guy. So have fun with Spider-Punk. Let me know what you think. There's been plenty of photographs online about this guy. But yeah, love to hear your thoughts and comments. I should mention in terms of size how big he is. Very quickly, let me do that. If you will stand good for me. Yes, you will. And he is, including his Mohican, just over 6 inches tall. And there he is in comparison to Crappy Hands, Infinity Wars, Spider-Man himself. Spider-Punk and Spider-Man. So, yeah, you can see obviously a much younger Spider-Man there, being a little bit shorter and smaller overall by about a head. But there you go. Let us know what you think of Spider-Punk. And again, if you want to pick him up, link below. If you like us, hit subscribe and all that crap. You know what to do. All right, see you soon. Bye.